Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I'm showcasing the Spellbinders card kit of the month. So this is the September card kit and it is called Express Yourself. First, let's take a look on what's included and then I'm going to share 6 cards using products from the kit. Now, just like always, it is packed with products. It is a kit that is a great value for money and you get everything for less than $40. So first of all, you will get pre-folded cards. These are 10 and 10 envelopes. In the kit, you always get this card that gives you some ideas on how you can put together a few cards, and at the back there are also instructions. You will get 2 types of adhesive in the kit, so some foam tape as well as a double-sided tape. Now, the dies included this month are really unique. I haven't seen anything like it before. So these actually create a letterboard. So you can create the frame as well as the inside, and they give you little letters, all the whole alphabet. So you can cut out and spell anything you like. I will create one of those cards so you can see how you can put everything together. The stamp set is a combination of a couple of fonts. You can mix and match them together. It's one of those sentiment stamp sets that you will be using again and again, since it is really versatile. Every month, one of my favorite things from the kit are the die-cut shapes. You get not only designs, but also sentiments that you can mix and match. And I absolutely love this because they give you the opportunity to create really quick and easy cards. I'm going to show you many cards today and how you can easily pull together something by just picking die-cuts from this set. There are tons of them, so you can create many, many cards, and you have duplicates for its design, so you can easily recreate something. And I don't know if you can tell, but some of them have a lovely foiling. You also get a pack of gemstones in lovely colors that match the color theme of the kit, and they do have glitter on top. I don't know if the camera catches that, but they are really beautiful and very unique. There is also a pack with chipboard embellishments. These are stickers. They are self-adhesive and they are quite thick. Hopefully you can see how thick they are, nice and sturdy, so you can stick them as focal points on your projects. Just like always, you will get a paper pad. This is a 6x6 paper pad. They are one-sided and you get 2 times each design. If you follow me for quite some time, you already know that I love pattern paper and I will be using many of these pages today on the upcoming cards. So let's take a look at the cardstock. You get 9 different colors and one of them is gold. So let's start with some cards. I'm going to demonstrate how quick and simple it is to create cards using products from this kit. So first of all, I used one of the pattern papers. I cut it out to size. And now just for some extra something, I'm adding some splashes. These are from a gold spray and you will find it linked down below. This is not something that you have to do, but it really adds something extra on the paper. Now I'm going to stick that on top of my pink cardstock that was included in the kit. Now on top, I'm going to create a flower arrangement. There are many different designs of flowers and leaves in the kit, so you can mix and match and create your own. I am using foam squares at the back and I'm going to place them together, pop them on my card, and then underneath I'm going to place the sentiment as well as the leaves. It is a very quick and simple design, very versatile for pretty much any occasion, and you can easily recreate it by using all the different types of flowers that you get in the kit. So here are some close-up photos on the first card, and let's move on to the next one. For this card, I chose the pattern paper that has this wooden design. And for my card base, I went with the off-white one. I think this is very light gray. And I'm cutting it out to be 4¼ by 5½. I'm going to mat that on top and I'm just going to add some tape adhesive at the back and stick it there, making sure that I have a border on the left and on the right. Now, when you try to pick up pieces from the cutouts that mix and match together nicely, make sure that they have the same details. So, for example, my flower here has some foiling all around, so I picked the green leaves that have foiling as well, and also the completely gold leaves. I am adding some foam squares at the back to pop my flower and then I'm going to stick down the leaves. And I'm creating a little bit of a cluster here. And for the sentiment, I went with two of the die cuts. And if you combine them, you can read, "You are the real deal." Again, both of those sentiments are foiled, which means that everything matches perfectly on top of my card. And also notice that I'm using the whole thing of that foam adhesive that they give me, not only the squares, but also the outside area. So the second card idea is exactly the same as the first one, where I create a flower composition on top, but just by using different designs of die cuts, I create a completely different look. Now for the third card, I'm going for something masculine, so I picked up that lovely pattern paper, which I'm going to combine it with the grey cardstock. And I'm using my basic rectangle dies that I had on my stash to create a frame. I used foam tape at the back and I'm going to stick that frame directly on top of my card base. And now this gives some dimension, but it is not a shaker card. Of course, you can turn it into a shaker card if you want to. Now, as my focal point, I went with the car, and just to give some more definition to my card, I also used the rectangle dies to cut out this tiny little frame, which I'm going to stick on top. Now again for the car, I'm going to use some foam tape at the back and I'm going to stick it a little bit offset. If you want, you can recreate the same design and stick it at the center of the frame, but just for some variation, I decided to go offset for this one. And then to embellish it a little bit more, I'm using two more die cuts. One of them is the measure tape and the other one is one of the sentiments that says "No other dad like you." So these two die cuts not only embellish my card even more, but at the same time they provide kind of a ground for my car so that it doesn't look as if it is floating there. I'm also adding some dots of glue so that I can stick some of the golden stars, and these were included too. I usually make feminine cards, so when I end up making a masculine card, I'm always really happy, since it is always nice to have some of those cards on hand. For the next card, just for some variation, instead of creating the standard A2 card, I'm going for a gatefold card, so I will create two flaps that meet at the middle. I also picked up one of the beautiful pattern papers, and I think that this cardstock really complements that pattern paper. And from this pattern paper, I'm going to cut out 2-inch strips so that I can embellish the flaps of my card. I'm using my tape runner at the back of those pattern papers and I'm going to stick them on the flaps. Make sure that when you close those flaps, that design on the pattern paper is continuous. However, I made sure that I left a little bit of a border there at the center to add some interest. Now I'm using one of my basic dies. This is a circle die which I am placing on top. I'm going to secure it down with some purple tape only on one side of the flap, then open up the card completely, run it through my die cutting machine, and then I'm going to repeat the same process for the other flap. Always make sure that you open up the card as you run it through your die cutting machine, since you don't want to make a hole at the back of your card. So here I have done the die cutting on one of the flaps. Now I am removing my purple tape so that I can open up the card and run it one more time through my die cutting machine. And here is what I end up having. Now when I picked the circle die, I made sure that that die was slightly bigger than this chipboard embellishment so that I can place it at the center. On the inside, there is plenty of space to write your personal message. I would go with a white gel pen to write it down. And then you can keep your card close by tying, for example, a ribbon. Just make sure that it matches the colors of your card. This is one of those designs that really showcase the beautiful design of a pattern paper, since you don't really cover it up with anything. And it is the star of the card. For the next card, I'm going to combine those two pattern papers and I'm also going to mix and match die cut shapes as well as chipboard embellishments to create a little cluster. So you can see the process here, how I'm playing with different chipboard elements. So I'm sticking the sentiment on top of that frame. And now I'm trying to decide whether I want the whole pattern paper at the back or just a piece of it. So decided only to back the frame, and that's why I'm pressing it hard. These stickers are not very sticky, so they are really forgiving, but if you want to make sure that they are going to stay put, I would suggest to add a little bit of glue, like I am doing here, just to make sure that this is not going to go anywhere. I also picked up a few of the leaves, which I am going to stick underneath. I also picked up a few of the leaves, which I'm going to tag underneath the sentiment. And I have a piece of cardstock here, which is a leftover from the second card, I believe. I am placing it at the center. And then on top, I'm going to add the little frame that I created. Again, using foam tape at the back, just because I love dimension. And now I want to embellish it a little bit more and add even more stickers. So here I am using one that says Timeless. And I'm also going to stick down one of those cutouts that says Good Things. And I also created this fishtail ribbon out of the gold cardstock. And when you are creating clusters like that, it's always nice to use glue at the back instead of tape adhesive. This is more forgiving and you can move things around before the glue is completely dry if you are not happy with the placement. Now I am adding some finishing touches, some pink gemstones from the kit, and I didn't like the black strip as it is at the moment, so here is where I decided that I need to turn it into a fishtail so that it matches my gold ribbon. Now my panel is ready. All I have to do is to stick it on top of one of my card bases, and here are some close-up photos. And finally, let's move on to the last card for today, where I am going to demonstrate how you can put together the letterboard using the dies from the kit. So I have cut out the borders out of gold cardstock and the inside pieces out of white cardstock. I am adding tape adhesive at the back of those panels, and I love the tape that was included in the kit just because it is very thin and it fits nicely at the back. And now it is really easy to put everything together. Just remove the tape. Stick the first one on top of the white piece. I'm going to add the borders on the left and on the right. And then I will continue at the back, adding one white piece underneath another. And of course I decided to have my letterboard white with gold frame, but you can go with black letterboard if you want to and add white letters on top. It really depends on your design. And here is how my letterboard looks like. I used the dies from the kit to cut out letters, and I want to spell enjoy the ride. The fun part about this is that you can spell out anything you like. You can see here my method of sticking them down with glue. But of course you can use some double-sided adhesive at the back of your paper before you cut out the letters, so turn them into stickers if you think that is easier. I used glue at the back of my letterboard, and I'm going to stick that on top of this pattern paper. And to embellish it, I'm going to use the bicycle. The dies also give you flowers as well as leaves that you can cut out if you want to. I am going to finish off my card by adding some of the golden stars as well as one of the sentiments that says this is my happy. And that finishes the last card for today. In the close-up photos you will be able to see a better look on that letterboard and imagine how gorgeous it would look if it was black with white letters on top. So let's take a quick look on all the 6 cards that I created for today using products from the Card Kit of the Month by Spellbinders. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired to create some fun cards using die cuts and pattern paper. Don't forget, you will find the full list of all the supplies down below in the description area, just like always. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.